Hello everyone. Today I'll be reviewing this Barlow lens that I got from Svbony. It was delivered to me a few days ago and I was really excited to test this. Svbony sells Barlows with three magnifications, 5x, 3x and 2x. I went for the 2x version because the other two are a bit too much for me. For those who are not sure what Barlow is, basically, it's a device that allows you amazing magnification. So you can use these to get a better reach. This 2x Barlow lens, for example, essentially doubles your focal length. You can use this to get better details of Jupiter or get a closer look at the rings of Saturn. This particular Barlow is made for 1.25 inches scopes. Thankfully, this is not made with cheap plastic. I think the material used is good quality aluminium, which gives it a good solid feel. Overall, it's a good nice finish. What I love about this is that you can attach this both to your camera and use this with eyepieces. To put it on your DSLR, just unscrew the threaded part of your T-ring and screw this in instead. You can also thread the only glass bit to your T-ring, just like any other filter. You can also use this with planetary cameras that fit in very nicely. Clearly, the makers of this little device wanted this to be multi-purpose and serve many needs. By the way, the thread interface is M42 and 0.75. The lens edges and inner barrel are blackened to help with contrast. In terms of optics, the thing that you look for in Barlow lenses is how much chromatic aberration they've got. Let me show you a few photos that I took with this. Here's a photo without Barlow, and here's a photo with Barlow on. As you can see, the magnification works very nicely and is in usable quality. Since we've come to an end of planetary season, I didn't quite get a chance to use it on planets, unfortunately. But I promise you, once the moon is out or when planets come back around, I will be first to post a picture link in the comment sections to give you a full report. But this should behave as good during the day. When I used it to take these photos, if you zoom right in, you can notice a little tiny bit of chromatic aberration, which is hardly noticeable to me. For me, it's a bit irrelevant because I take monochrome photos of planets. Overall, considering such a low price and reasonably good quality, I would recommend this for visual work as well as for mono astrophotography. You can use this for a color camera too if you don't mind a little tiny bit of chromatic aberration. Well, I hope you found this helpful. If so, please subscribe for more.